basically decided that from the start of a drive to when you park, you shouldn't have to touch our device.
So throughout one drive, for the sake of convenience, we want to make sure that the use of our product took less time than simply completely powering off the phone and powering it back on. In the data we took, we found that on average, an iPhone takes approximately 39 seconds to power off and power back on, while an Android takes approximately 33 seconds to accomplish the same task.
So safety
data to either a parent device or a trucking driver employer device who would keep track of the use of the product.
Okay, so now that we had a finished product, we realized that we had to go through our testing to make sure all of our design specifications had been hit. So to start that off, we decided to make sure that it didn't create a blind spot, so we called in users to try just sitting in a car with the device attached and ask them if it blocked any windshield or windows, which it did not. And you can also see on this picture that if you're sitting in the driver's seat, it won't stop you from seeing the road. So we call this a success.
It actually verified that all the functions of the box can be used while driving without having to interact with the box. We tested this by showing that it's possible to access the phone and what's in the box without taking it out first.
So here we recorded the
there's certainly that type of aspect would be, you know, a really attractive aspect to using. Because, you know, the question I have for you is, you know, maybe I'm asking this for your parents, but would you guys actually use this device?
Well, the goal of this device, the target market isn't necessarily the student who is electing to put this restriction on themselves. The selling point of this product is the fact that it records this data and sends it off to a parent device over Bluetooth. So the idea is if you don't use it, then the parent will remember. Or if this was applied to a possible trucking company or Uber driver, some sort of situation where it's a commercial driving situation, this data can also be sent to the, you know, corporate.
That was actually my question as well. I didn't quite get that connection about why a person wants to use it, right? Because I didn't get the video game bonus, so I get it now. So you're basically reporting to the parent or whoever the authority is. You may want to think about the insurance company is another area that you can get a credit for. The question, I guess, that was the part we, I think, we didn't get. But I think now we understand what the vote is. The mounting, did you mount that on a vent, or just kind of, just the weight, look at the weight and the mounting methodology. Can you talk about that a bit?
Yeah, there's an option to mount it on a vent, as well as just to mount it using suction to the dash itself with the stand.
Did you guys weigh it or anything, or get an idea what kind of load you put on that?
It's about 2 phones if you're talking about like a Samsung or an iPhone, one of the newer ones. So it is heavier, but we haven't seen any signs that it being heavier has led to any issues with the mounting.
And the last question I had was the LED. So the LED right there, right? That was kind of cool. It's a quick video. What's the purpose of that LED? Tell me. Looks like a 4-liner or 2-liner.
Yeah, so the purpose of the display is to give localized, not just to be shipping the data off and have it be like a black box that's totally unknown to the actual driver user. The display is the place where the driver could see a game drive, like how consistent they were.
So it's a feedback.
Yeah. So it's just a feedback thing. It displays stuff like how long it's in, how long it's the car's been on the total, and then how many times. I mean, instances there were where a phone was actually pulled it out and removed from the device.
From that far away, it might not look like a display. It might just look like an LED. But there are numbers on here that you can see.
Yeah, I'm not a good video on it because it's an added feature. I could do it on the phone, but I just
Thank
you.
I really like the enhancements that you did on the product. I think making sure that it's a real phone in the way that you enhance that to make sure that it's even to the wireless charger. I think that's really a great enhancement and a great opportunity for one to put it in there. I think in terms of, I didn't realize you had a budget, but how much money did you spend on this? And did you come in under budget, over budget, or?
We ended up